Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand recursion in C. To understand, for better understanding, in our previous class, we have covered about process of a program. So this concept we have already covered in our previous video. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video, because the understanding of recursion totally based upon that previous concept. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now, coming to this class, we'll try to understand about recursion in C. What is meant by recursion? Recursion function. Recursion means it is a mechanism which is used to solve the problems, and recursion means it is a function calling itself. If a function is calling itself, it is what we call it as recursive function. And those recursive functions, using those recursive functions, we can solve the problems. And how can we solve that is, it is totally based upon this concept. This is how a process will be created for a program, and based upon this concept, the concept of recursion has been evolved. So let's try to understand the concept of recursion by using this example. This example is a factorial example. So finding the factorial of a number. This example is finding the factorial of a number, and let's try to understand how a factorial can be found, how the factorial value can be obtained by using the recursion. So by using recursion, how can we get the factorial? First, as we have discussed in that video where we have discussed that whenever a function call is made, a new activation record will get created in the stack. This we have already discussed. So this is our stack. This is our stack. And whenever a new function call is made, an activation record will get created. And this activation record is for main. So what happens within this activation record is, it is going to create the local variables. So what are the local variables? It is int I. So scanf is done and the value of I is 4. Assume that the value of I is 4, and here enter the number to find the factorial. So user is going to enter a number. For example, assume that he has entered the value of I is equal to 4, means we have to find the factorial of 4. And here factorial of %d is %d I fact of I. Another function call is made. So here is where a new activation record will get created. So here is where we are going to jump. So this is what we call it as instruction pointer. Here it is, we are going to remember from where the execution has to start, from the fourth line. So here we are given the line numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. In the fourth line, we have stopped the sequence of execution and we have jumped to some other place. Where that place is? To this place. Okay, and what is that? With the value of I is equal to 4. So the function call is fact of 4. Fact of 4. With that function call, this is the function call. For every function call, a new activation record will get created. So now we are here in this function. So what's happening in this function? Let's try to understand. Here fact of 4. So a new activation record has been created. Now the value of n is equal to 4. In this factorial function, fact of 4, the value of n is equal to 4. Is n less than or equal to 1? No. So we are going to come into this else statement. Return n into fact of. So where we are going to stop? In the line number 7, another function call is made with f of. So we are going to consider it as f for fact. Fact of n minus 1. Fact of n minus 1. Another function call. This is what we call it as recursion. A function calling itself. Again the function call is made. So fact of 3. The function call fact of 3 is made. Okay. it is f of 3. F of 3 means fact of 3. So in order to make it short, we have written it as f of 3. Again the function call is made. Here the value of n is equal to 3. Okay, so n is equal to 3. And now is the value of n less than or equal to 1? No, it is not. It is greater than 1. So again this return will get executed. At this return statement we are again shifting a new function call is made. So that is important to understand. At the 7th line, n into f of 2, a new function call has been made. So a new activation record will get created. So we'll get the clarity in the last point. We'll get the complete clarity. N is equal to 2. Again, is the value of n less than or equal to n? Yes. So is it less than or equal to 1? No, it is not less than or equal to 1. So this else part will get executed. Return n into fact of n minus 1. Return n into, this is where we are going to stop its execution. This function's execution will get stopped and a new function call is made. That is the point that you have to understand at the 7th line. Okay, so again f of 1, where the value of n is equal to 1. And here is the point that you have to understand. Again, fact f of 1, n is equal to 1, n value is equal to 1. Okay, now is the value of n less than or equal to 1? Yes, it is equal to 1. If it is equal to 1, return 1. So return 1 means where this return value has to be forwarded. This return value has to be sent. Where it has to sent? To the calling function. What is the calling function? This is the calling function. To this calling function, what we have to return? We have to return 1. We have to return 1. So this part is not getting created in the activation record. For understanding, we have written it. In the activation record, we will be having only values of the variables. Okay, so here value of 1 will be forwarded. So this is going to return 1 to this f of 1. So now what is the value of n here? It is 2 into 1. It is 2. The value of n is 2. See here, the value of n is 2. So here the return value of this function call is 1. 2 into 1 is 2. And this, where it will get returned, this value of n into 1, 2 into 1 will be returned, 2 into 1 will be returned to f of 2. What is this 2 into 1? 2. So this 2 value will be returned here and the n value is 3 in this. So after this will be deleted after executing. So after 7th line, these two lines will get executed, will be written back, and this function call will end. This function f of 2 will end. This will be deleted. So this the multiplication value of 2 into 1 will be returned back here to this function call, where the function call has been generated. Okay, so 3 into 2, which is equal to 6, and this return value has to be forwarded to f of 3. So this function has been created because of this function call. So that value has to be returned. What it has to return? It has to return 6. That 6 will be stored here. And this n value is 4. See here, n value is 4. 4 into 6, which is equal to 24. So where this first call f of 4 has been generated in this printf. Okay, in this printf, fact of 4 has been generated. So now this 24 will be written back here. So it is going to print 4, value of %i. The factorial of 4 is 24. So this value is 24. It is going to print the factorial of 4 is 24. So that will get printed. See how the recursive functions, based upon the concept of process, we were able to solve the problems using recursive function calls. A function calling itself, we were able to find the factorial. That is done because this is how the process will, a program will get executed by using a process. Okay. So this is all about recursive function. Recursive function means a function calling itself. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.